Hi there. I welcome you to today's video lesson. In our recent video lesson, we talked about Erwin Schrödinger's role in the discovery of the atom, specifically the quantum mechanical model. We talked about how Schrödinger derived an equation popularly known as the Schrödinger equation that enabled him to predict the position of an electron within a given period of a time in the atom. In today's video lesson, which is the discovery of the atom and the subatomic particle, part 6, we will be talking about how another scientist by the name James Chadwick discovered one of the subatomic particles. James Chadwick was born in 20th October 1891 and died in 20th July 1971. Chadwick discovered the neutron, which is one of the subatomic particles, in 1932 and was awarded a Nobel Prize for Physics in 1935. So that is a picture of James Chadwick. Now, after Rutherford discovered the nucleus and as a result the protons, his observation and then conclusion was successful at explaining the scattering of alpha particles. But there was a problem when the experimental data were used to calculate the mass of the nucleus. From the result of his experiment, it was possible to calculate the charge on the nucleus. However, the mass of these protons was only about half the overall mass of the nucleus. And this brought in another question, that if one of the subatomic particles, that is the proton, which is within the nucleus, if the mass of it is about half of the entire mass of the nucleus, then it means that there is another particle within, either there is another or either one particles or more than one particles within the nucleus. So one scientist by the name William Harkins suggested that the missing mass could be accounted for if the nucleus contained other particles with mass similar to that of proton, but no charge. So James Chadwick finally discovered the neutrons in the nucleus by bombarding a thin sheet of beryllium with an alpha particle, that's beryllium atom, or as an element. He observed the emission of a high energy radiation similar to gamma waves. These radiations has no charge but a mass slightly greater than or same as that of protons. That was what he observed. So at the end, he concluded that the radiations that emitted during his experiment has a very high penetrating power. The radiations remain unaffected in an electric or magnetic field. In other words, electric and magnetic field couldn't affect or couldn't influence this radiation, meaning they were not carrying charges. They were neutral. They were chargeless particles. Thirdly, he said that the particles constituting the radiation had the same mass as that of proton. He did that by placing a paraffin wax. We will talk about that soon. When paraffin wax gets hit by the chargeless particles, that is these high energy radiations, protons were shot out from the paraffin, indicating that it has the same size as that of proton. Yeah, so that is the reason why he made mention of the fact that the particles constituting the radiation had the same mass as that of proton. Yes, because when these higher energy radiations pass through paraffin wax, what happened is that protons were knocked out or were shot out from the paraffin. I want you to take note of that. So he identified these chargeless particles as neutrons. So the person who discovered another subatomic particle by the name neutrons is James Chadwick. And I want you to take note of the fact that it is William Huggins who gave the name neutrons. Yes, and not Chadwick, even though Chadwick discovered the neutrons, but Williams gave the name neutrons. All right, so this is what he did. This diagram is giving us a mental picture of what Chadwick did. So we have a source of alpha particle here in this lead block. This alpha particle, and then as we said, he bombarded a thin sheet of beryllium. The reason why we say all boron is that you can use boron in replacement of beryllium, but what Chadwick used was beryllium. I want you to take note of that. Yes, so these alpha particles pass through the beryllium and high energy radiation were emitted. So this is a radiation, and then he brought in paraffin wax in front of the radiations, and then they knock out protons out, indicating that these high energy radiation were not protons. They were different particles apart from protons. Yes, so I want you to also take note of that. The modern structure of the atom. So from Dalton to Chadwick, we've learned that Dalton came out with a model about the atom, that is the Dalton atomic theory. And then from there we talk about Joseph John Thomson cathode ray tube or discharge tube experiment. From there we move, which led to the discovery of the electrons. And then from there we move on to Ernest Rutherford alpha scattering experiment, which led to the discovery of the nucleus and one of the subatomic particles, proton. Then from there we talk about Bohr's model of the atom. We also talk about the fact that the electrons orbits around the nucleus in a stationary state. We talk about that. That is termed as the shells. All right, and from there to talk about the quantum mechanical model by Erwin Schrödinger. So, and then lastly, James Chadwick, discovery of the neutrons as one of the subatomic particles within the nucleus of an atom. So all these people contribution sum up in what is termed as the modern structure of the atom. So the structure of the atom formulated by scientists in this modern era is: the atom is made up of electrons, protons, and neutrons, which constitute the subatomic particles. As I said at the early stage, when we started with the discovery of the atom and the subatomic particles, I made mention of the fact that the protons, electrons, and neutrons are not the only subatomic particles. We have the meson, we have the neutrino, hyperon, antineutrino, quarks, leptons. All these are subatomic particles. But I made mention of the fact that these three, that is electrons, protons, and neutrons, are the first subatomic particles, the first three subatomic particles that were discovered. I want you to take note of that. But they are not the only subatomic particles that we have. The neutrons have no charge. It's chargeless. The protons are positively charged and the electrons are negatively charged. Take note of that. The number of protons balance the number of electrons, giving a neutral atom. So when we pick any neutral atom, the number of protons are equal to the number of electrons. And thirdly, protons and neutrons are found within the nucleus of the atom. And they are termed as the nucleon. Yes. And electrons move around the nucleus in energy levels or shells. Each shell has a subshell or shells called orbitals. I want you to take note that the electrons within the shells, they are found within the orbitals. So when you pick any atom, where the electrons are found, the electrons are in the shells. But within the shell, we have something called orbitals. So it is within the orbitals that the electrons are. So the orbitals are a subset of the shell. And within the orbitals, that is where you will find the electrons. So an orbital is any empty space within the atom, specifically within the atomic shell, where there is a higher probability of locating an electron. Any empty space within the shell of an atom where there is a higher probability of locating an electron is termed as an orbital. So we pick the atom within the shells, we have orbitals, and within the orbitals, we have the electrons. That is where electrons are. So mind you, electrons are not just in the shells. They are inside the orbitals, which is within the shell. So I want you to take note of that. So this is a typical modern day structure of the atom. So we have this being the shells. Is the shell. Yes, the shell. The shell. These are the shells. So within there we have the orbitals in which the electrons are located. Very good. So this is an electron. Then at the center of the atom we have the nucleus. You have the nucleus as the center, the central part. At the early stage we learned that the atom has a central core according to Rutherford model of the atom. The atom has a central core called the nucleus. And within the nucleus, we have the positive particles termed as the protons. And then we have a chargeless particle known as the neutrons. So the protons and the neutrons are found within the nucleus of the atom. And the electrons are found within the orbitals, found within the shells of the atom. So this is a typical example of the atom. In summary, each subatomic particle, that is the neutron, the proton, and the electrons, have a location within the atom as we were just talking about. They have a mass and then a charge. Or chargeless. So we have the neutron located in the nucleus, a mass of one atomic mass unit, and then the charge is neutral, it's chargeless. Then we have another particle, proton, located within the nucleus, mass of one atomic mass unit, a charge of positive or plus. Electron located within the electron clouds, as Schrodinger said, yes, or within the energy levels, within orbitals. And then the mass is zero, not necessarily zero, it is 1/1,840, so you get 0.005, yes, so, but approximately, when you run it to the nearest whole number, it will be zero. Yes. Then the charge is negative one. So negatively charged. I want you to take note of that. So Neutron is represented by N, proton P, and electron E. So when we come to this side, we have electrons, protons, and neutrons. So the electrons are present outside the nucleus of the atom. Protons are inside the nucleus of the atom. Neutrons are present inside the nucleus of the atom. Electrons are negatively charged. Protons are positively charged. Neutrons are neutral. And mass of electron is considered to be negligible. The mass of proton is approximately 2,000 times the mass of electron. The mass of neutron is nearly equal to that of proton, and electron is denoted by E, proton by P, neutron by N. So this will bring us to the end of this video lesson. Don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to like, don't forget to comment. And also, below this very lesson is a link to the quantum mechanical model of the atom, and you'll find some other link to our early video lessons. Also, there is a WhatsApp link there, you can click on it, and if you want to contact me one-on-one, you can reach me through that WhatsApp link. There is also another link, which is our Facebook page link. You can click on it and like our Facebook page and ask any question in there for other chemistry-minded people to share their opinions concerning your question. I remain your facilitator, Dozerman, the hypothetical chemist, chemistry. Jesus is the strongest.